there, welcome back to our video. This one is going to be Why Don't You Just Die, which is available from Arrow. You can also get it streaming from Arrow. And it's the debut of director Kirill Sokolov, Russian director. This is hilarious, low budget debut. This is one of those ones that's like, I want to see this director do more. Like, there's obviously some, a lot of talent there. And you can hope he doesn't follow the route of the director of the Nightwatch series, where he started off interest and then made these trashier films, and now it's like, well, where was the talent gone? You know, hopefully they'll develop in more interesting ways. So this one is a thriller made by a guy who likes horror movies. It's the best way I can put it. It's kind of like Blood Simple in that way, where you can tell there's an influence of horror, but it's basically a thriller setup. And it's all about this dysfunctional family, led by this policeman who's viewed as a brute, completely corrupt. And in the beginning, this guy comes in to kill him. And it leads to one of the most brutal fight scenes in one location you never think of. And it's also cartoonish and hilarious and a lot of dark humour. And it does have a very Sam Raimi type influence. It's probably the moment where the film is most Sam Raimi-ish. Because it ends up with Sam Raimi, because there's got a lot of interest in camera moves and, you know, the same way the Wachowskis, when they first started out in Bound, was very influenced by Sam Raimi, and then they moved on to their own style. It does have that, but it moves on to its own style within this first film anyway. I mean, even after the first section of this, it goes into a more Coen Brothers kind of, like, subdued style in the setup, but it's still kind of hyper in a lot of different ways. But it kind of pulls back and lets the actors act rather than keep going woo, 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 type of thing. But it's influenced by lots of stuff. So it's influenced by the Coen Brothers, both the early stuff and the later stuff. It's influenced by Sam Raimi, who's also a collaborator with the Coen Brothers. It's that kind of, it's obviously made by someone who watched these films a lot when he was young. But it is a crime film, so you get this situation where this guy suddenly attacked this cop, and now he's trapped in the house, and he's locked behind handcuffs and in the bathroom. And he tells the father that he was told by his daughter that he'd abused her, and he was going to kill him for that. And then you start to go back in time and find out lots of other stuff. You find out the point of view of the guy who was coming to the attack. You find out the point of view of the daughter, what she was about. You find out what's happening with the guy himself, the cop himself, what happened with his partner, what's happening with the mother of the wife of the guy, of the cop, but the mother of the woman who said her father abused her. There's all these slowly unwinding plot details that start to unfold slowly but surely, and you start to get a sense of who the characters actually are. Not the kind of melodramatic kind of cartoonish style you see in the first few 10 minutes. It starts to become much more depth to them. It's like, no, there's more to them than this. But it's also a film with a dark sense of humour about humanity, about the way people act, the way people behave to each other, the way people view each other. But it's done in a thriller format, and it's just always there to entertain you rather than make any social point. It's about, basically, it's a 5 or 6 people in a room movie, basically, with a few scenes where they go outside and you see them interact with a few other people. But you could do this as a play, basically. If you find a way to do a couple of the stunts in the first section, you could do it as a play and then have a side location for 1 or 2 moments and then come back to the stage. So that kind of enclosed environment. So again, it's got that enclosed thing like Reservoir Dogs had, or Evil Dead had, or a bigger budget version of Thing had. This sense of people trapped in this location, and they're basically trapped within the limitations of their lives. You know, because they're all kind of trapped within, they're in Russia, there is a social system that you have to basically deal with. You have to survive within. And there are limitations. And there are limitations also what you can do with your life. And it's that drives a lot of people into bad decisions that affect them. So again, like the Coen Brothers films, there's a sense of people making mistakes that if they just showed a bit more foresight, they would have survived fine. But instead, they doomed themselves by going for some, you know, easy money. But it's also a very funny film. It's a very darkly humorous film. It is very stylish, even though the style just calmed down a lot as it goes. There's still a lot of flourishes. But it's just, it's not quite like Rami Camp thing. It's much more subdued than that a lot of the time. It's just like somebody just people in a room talking, and then you suddenly do the kind of extreme kind of shots. Whenever you're one person, that's when the camera gets more expressive. I just try to see them think their way through something. The conversational thing, it feels a little bit more, not more like a Coen Brothers film, which is a good thing, but it is more cartoonish than a Coen Brothers film. I'm trying to get at it. It's not as grounded as the Coen Brothers like to make their films. Coen Brothers make their films grounded, but also a little bit out of reality. This one's a bit more cartoony. But it's a respect for the idea that you've seen all these kind of films before, you know what the conventions are, you know what to expect, so it doesn't have to like go 100 miles an hour all the time. It knows there's enough backstory to keep you interested in the story that it doesn't have to over-stylize it all the time and make you a bit fed up. It knows when to calm down, is what I'm saying. And it does have nice moments. I mean, I was interested throughout. It keeps changing where it's going all the time, so you're always getting... You're getting one story, and that story leads to another story, leads to another story, leads to more developments that are always coming back to the main situation, but then you see it in different ways, so you can see why people react the way they are, and what their actual motivations are. So it's a very interesting first film. It's obviously a first film. It's got that kind of show-offy first film feel that this may be my last film, so I'm going to do certain things that are probably a bit nuts, you know. It does have that feeling, but it's also, it does have the kind of self-control, you know. It's not like Hardcore Henry, which I remember when I saw that one, it was just too much. It was just always going too far. It was like almost like, we can't break, because then you'll notice holes in the plot. That's why it's much more confident. So, I definitely recommend it. I'm trying not to go into any more details. You should see for yourself. I'm trying to avoid plot spoilers beyond. This is a basic setup, what you need to know. So this is a short video, but you should definitely watch this film. It's really enjoyable. Okay, that's me for now. I'll be back soon for another video. See you later.